that is our early time of this tabernacle is dissolved. We have a built on God, not made with hands, eternal in the heaven. We brought nothing of truth into this world, and it is certainty to carry this out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He restored my soul. He redeemed me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord. This is Psalm 34.
Thank you. today right now, Lord. We ask you to protect them, to guide them, and lead them, Lord. Lead them into righteousness, Lord. Help them to follow the way of the truth, Lord. We just ask you to bless each and every one right now as they leave here to go to their separate homes, Lord. We ask you just to protect their home, protect them, and lead them, Lord. We ask all these things in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
They're going to keep everything brief but beautiful, brief but great, brief but wonderful for our brother that's gone on, and we have him to his family, our family. I'm not going to make too many remarks because I don't want to take from those that have something to say. So at this time, we have a selection coming from Sister Tricia Smith and Sister Crystal Santiago. Take me to the King. This is
Refuses to die. Oh, yeah. hard for me. And we have went by, and he said to me,
my wife, we were headed somewhere.
And he looked at her,
my beautiful wife, and he said,
he called me,
oh, no way, you let your wife out of the house like this? Done one of the things that nobody else can do. He brought us all together. One more time. So while we are together, let's embrace each other, love, and cherish his memory. Cherish it. Because time is shorter than what we think. Short. So much shorter. So, Sister Liz, don't you worry. It's going to be all right. The Lord will strengthen you. And if I look around me here, I see everybody up here, everybody that done went through the same thing that you're going through. And I have definitely lost loved ones. I lost two at one time. But in all of that, I can't say that I know what your pain is. Because the Lord gave you your pain. And he gave me my suffering. But I know that there is suffering, and we must go through. We don't have no choice, but the Lord is good this morning. So let me say to you on behalf of the deacons, be blessed. Remember, and keep yourself, and keep your mind on the Lord. All you that come from far away, Arkansas, or wherever you came from, the Lord on your mind when you get ready to go back down that highway.
last forever, and at one point, we all must die. What do you say for comfort? Or how do you say goodbye? Losing a loved one hurts the heart, and your faith is put to the test. Understand there's no more suffering, and your loved one can now rest. You may not understand God's purpose, but believe it does exist. Even though we don't want to accept it, His name has to be accepted. Never wanting problems, always full of love and avoiding strife. He was a
son,
brother, father, a vivid individual living life.
Dear God, I know you never said, oh, I said, dear God, I know you said never put man before you. But I need a pass right now. And I pray that you forgive me, and I pray that you shine light on my cousin Terrence. So it was good. He was original. He was like nobody else. You know what I mean? This is not even what I wrote, man. It just, I mean. I know that you. I just want you to guide Terrence in the right direction. Show him where his home at. You know, we lost a lot of family. And other people that's not our family, they lost family. But the people that's not here, I know they got. I've never been there before. So what I'm saying is, the people who's on this earth, they've been here, so they know how it feels to be here, and it's like they standing on the glass. They can't come back in. And God, I just want you to show them it's a place outside of life, you know what I'm saying? Because it was a born date, it's a death date. And I'm just more frustrated and sad and mad at them. I just don't know what's going on right now. My mind is everywhere. I'm trying to hold myself together. Terrence, you can hear me right now, bro. You know what I mean? Find your way home, B. You know what I'm saying?
Was somebody you could just talk to. You didn't feel, have to feel uncomfortable or anything. I was working on his friends. He was such a great guy. And he actually stopped me from killing myself.
child of God. Oh yeah. Play, hey. God's got you now. I know that. God's got you. He's got the whole world in his hands. Don't worry. Don't lose faith. God will never leave you in despair. Keep on your trust in God. You did.
That's why he was living.
He always told me to protect my sister and brother.
Thank you.
everybody.
Send him off right.
Tell you.
can do better than that. I said, put your hands together for Jesus. Put your hands together for Brother Terrence one more time. Storms keep on raging. As I
As you bid farewell to Mr. Terrence D., we remember the words of the psalmist David in Psalms 30 and 5 that says, "Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning." And sad hour, recall the happy moments and glad times spent with Terrence and allow those tears of sorrow to become tears of joy and remembrance of him. We commend you to look to the hills from whence cometh your help, for all of your help comes from the Lord. The Curry, Dean, and Smith families shall forever be in our thoughts and prayers. Submitted this 30th day of October in the year of 2020. With deepest sympathy, the True Apostolic Church of Jesus Christ of Orlando, Florida, Bishop Ernie Jones, pastor, Sister Karen Hamilton, secretary. Church resolution to the family and respect of Terrence D. We, the members of the Church of Jesus Christ Incorporated, want Brother and Sister Curry and all the family of Terrence Dean to know that our hearts, thoughts, and prayers are with you during this time. As Psalms 121 says, "I will lift up mine eyes into the hills from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord, which made heaven and earth." The Lord will be there to see you through with each day to comfort you. We remember Terrence growing up around the church, from a little boy to a young man. He was a kind-hearted, respectful, and loving person who often greeted you with open arms. Nobody was a stranger. He was and is truly loved by many. He will be greatly missed, but always remembered. Family, keep his memory alive and all the happy times you shared with him. We may not always understand the reason of God or why circumstances happen the way they do, but we do know that the Lord will be there to strengthen you day by day. Therefore, be it resolved that we embrace the will of the Lord, for we know that the judge of all the earth, he will be right. We love you all and are praying for you. Humbly submitted on this 30th day of October 2020 by Pastor Bishop Hubert Phillips, officers and members of the Church of Jesus Christ Incorporated, 16 Helena Street, Rochester, New York. Obituary. Terrence Cal D. entered this life on Saturday, March 12, 1988, in Augusta, Arkansas. He was born to Elizabeth J. Smith and Noble Green. After being just 2 weeks of age, Terrence, along with his mother and older sister Latoya, relocated to Rochester, New York in March of 1988. He attended elementary school at Enrico Firm School number 17 until the sixth grade, where he then went on to middle school at Churchville Chi-Line Middle School. After middle school, he attended high school at Edison Tech, where he was on the wrestling team. He also attended Spencer Court Senior High in Rochester, New York. He also lived with his Aunt Doris for 2 years while attending Board of Cooperative Educational Services, or BOCES. After high school, Terrence worked for EverDrive for 4 years. Terrence was an extremely hardworking man who loved and adored his children. His 3 children were his main reasons for working as hard as he did. If there was anyone that was a living example of a father who loved and worked hard and took care of all his children, it was Terrence. His 3 children were his life. Terrence also loved playing basketball and football with his cousins. His favorite NFL team was the Dallas Cowboys. Terrence was definitely the life of any get-together party to be had. There was never a dull moment or a moment where jokes weren't being cracked. When Terrence was around, sadly, Terrence departed his life on Monday, October 19, 2024. He leaves behind to mourn his passing his loving parents, Elizabeth J. and Charles R. Kirk.
Rochester, Arkansas.
Denevia Henderson.
Alexandria Winter McCoy. Zakiya Love McCoy. Gabriella Ann McCoy of Hope, New York.
Nyla
Zanai Smith of Martha, New York. Three nephews, Cajun, Deontay Smith, Jura of Ithaca, New York. One nephew, son of the 15 of Augusta, Arkansas. One goddaughter, Yana Scott Jackson.
See the same thing. For he will always be remembered. For he will always be loved. That's the message of the devil. But we thank God for his love, for his concern for this young man. I met this young man many times, and we talked all the time, praise the Lord. Always had something good to say. He was a very obedient child. Amen. We thank the Lord for him. Amen. I know once he was saved in the church, we are so happy for him. He left footprints behind that said, I love you. He was a man. He loved his children. He was dedicated to his children. Y'all young men be dedicated to your children. He worked. He got a testimony. Amen. We thank God for him. He made a way for us to be enriched by him. With the young man, you can look up to him. Pray God. Your family can look up to him. He's a great young man. Amen. We thank God for him. We thank God for you for coming. Amen. We understand we don't have a whole lot of time, but we have a little time to pray God. But we got to let you go. I love them. Brother Curry, Sister Curry, thank God for you. Amen. Amen. God is a good God. Amen. And his brother and his sister. Amen. It's a wonderful thing to have a good brother and a good sister. Pray for you.
Let
you have that. Pray for you. But God is good. Amen. He cares for you, please. And he cares for you all the time. Pray for you. God is good. He's a good God. Amen. And we love you. We thank the Lord for you and you and you and all that have come far in you. Amen. God is good. Amen. So we're going to turn you over. Amen. At this time, pray for God. God is good. Amen. To the cemetery. Gracious Father.